Namaskar learners, I am Professor Nishi Sethi. Earlier we interacted on two modules of video production, that is pre-production and production phase. Now I'll make you learn about the post-production phase of the video production. And the objectives of this video production lesson will be that I'll sensitize you people, my learners, about technical details of editing of a educational video. And also to make you aware about importance of evaluation of a video lesson and how we can do the evaluation. So I will cover about the types of editing, editing softwares, evaluation of video lesson, then important film script, some of the terminology which we generally use. So question arises, what is editing? Video editing is actually both an artistic as well as the technical process in which a collection of video material is compiled and altered from its original form to create a new version. The artistic process of video editing consists of deciding what elements to retain, what is to delete or combine from various sources so that they come together in an organized, logical and visually pleasing manner. The video lesson makes the final shape at the editing stage. So editing is the process of actually altering the sequence, scene, shortening, lengthening or eliminating the scene altogether. So then there are different types of video editings. Basically there are two, that is linear editing method and non-linear editing method. We generally use non-linear editing method, but in the linear editing method, that is the mechanical process and which is rarely used after computer dominance. It employs the use of camcorders, VCRs, edit controllers, titlers and mixers to perform the edit functions. The editing techniques is performed in linear steps. Linear editing consists again of three main categories. Number one is the in-camera editing. Video shots are structured in such a way that they are shot in order and of correct length. This process does not require any additional equipment other than the camcorder itself, but requires good shooting and organizational skills at the time of shoot. So this is a time-saving editing method, but this is possible when you have to shoot things very systematically in a sequence. Then the second is the assemble editing. This is also part of the linear editing, and video shots are not structured in a specific order during shooting, but are rearranged and unrequired shots are deleted at the time of transferring, or we can say copy. The original footage remains intact, but the rearranged footage is transferred to a new tape. Each scene or cut is assembled on a blank tape, either one at a time or in a sequence. Thirdly, the insert editing. New material is recorded over existing footage, and this technique can be used during the original shooting process or during a later editing process. Since the inserted footage is placed over the unwanted footage, some of the original footage is erased. So that is why these are mechanical in nature. Then comes the non-linear editing, and non-linear editing is gaining popularity quickly due to advances in technology, pricing and product availability. This method of video editing utilizes the computer environment to aid in the editing process. This process is almost entirely digital and employs no mechanical functions except for the input of the video sources and its final output to the pen drive, tape or hard disk or anything. And editing in this environment is essentially a visual cut and paste method. If we compare, linear and non-linear video editing techniques can be combined also. The basic concepts and rules of the video editing process are the same, but working in a digital environment allows the editor more creative freedom at each step in the process, such as being able to preview and correct each edit decision without having to go to the tape or the disc first. The video editing process then becomes similar to putting together a document or graphics presentation where the user cuts and pastes the segments together, adding effects and titles. Even audio editing is available. Once the video is finished, it can be dumped back and videotaped and then viewed or duplicated. Non-linear computer environment is the future of video editing, which requires a computer, a capture card, and right software. All footage is accessible anytime. You do not have to work sequentially. There are still plenty of applications for good old-fashioned tape-to-tape editing, especially if you are editing a long-form video project and want to keep your expenses down. Linear method of editing is most basic. You have to work consecutively. You cannot go back and shorten your scene or cut out a shot. Whereas non-linear editing require a computer, a capture card, and a right software, all footage is accessible anytime. You do not have to work sequentially. Common video editing softwares which we can use are various available even on the internet and in the market. And some of them to mention here are the Apple Final Cut Pro X, Apple iMovie, Coral Video Studio, Pinnacle Studio, Video Movie Maker, About Premiere Pro. Here I am mentioning only those which my students or my department has already used. So nothing there is to advertise some specific software. So we have to but ensure its compatibility with our computer. This is very important that it should match to your computer. Then there are certain points related to sound editing also. A production involving multiple microphones and subjects, it's best to have an audio recordist and mixer on the set. And once you have captured your audio, it's important to process it correctly during post-production. Sound mixing can be done in either the original shooting process or can be added during editing process. Audio dubbing is the technique of adding audio to footage that is already edited together or previously shot. The audio is added to the videotape without altering the previously recorded video and in some cases without altering the previously recorded audio. So when filming, you will often pick up some room tone or background noise in addition to your A-roll audio. So maybe the air conditioner or refrigerator, they kicked on and off during your recording and there is discrepancy in the sound. So hopefully you have recorded some room tone on location that you can use to lay under. So your audio to keep the sound consistent. You can then copy and paste those band aids of room tone in places where it should exist and does not. So you probably only need to do this if you do not have a music bed underneath the dialogue that would diminish or entirely cover the room tone. So you will sometimes need to even go through the process of denoising as well, which will remove ambient buzz or hum recorded during the production or noise introduced when increasing gain in post. So apply denoiser audio effect to your clips and adjust the reduction slider as necessary. If you slide too far, you can distort the tone of voice. So be sure to find that middle ground in which the background noise is removed, but the original sound of the speaking noise is preserved. So that has to be taken care of. So these are certain points related to the sound. Then comes the guidelines to be followed while doing the editing. And here we should know that special effects can be added at this stage depending upon your need. So select instrumental music or background or narration, vocal, rap or hip-hop music, whatsoever is required by you. Audience cannot follow two voice tracks at the same time. So keep proper logging of the material or the visual elements or any photographs, whatsoever is required, we can do the proper logging of those material and can be added at this particular editing stage. And so be sure to upload all source tapes before editing on your computer, that is photograph, slides, diagrams, charts, tables, film clips, video clips, animations, so can be employed to enrich your video. Then equipment compatibility is also paramount. If you want smooth, easy edit control, especially if you are not using computer, use all the same brand equipment. For example, if you are using Sony equipment, then all the equipment should be of Sony. JVC, then all the should be of JVC. The real key to being a successful video editor is time, patience, equipment that is easy for you to understand and work with, resourcefulness and good imagination. And this is important to do the editing yourself if you want to learn, or you can take help of someone if need be. So here I would like to show you how to do the editing on your screen. You can see and can try yourself. Then comes the last step, that is evaluation, and the task of video preparation does not cease at the editing stage, but how the message conveyed through media is decoded by the viewers. They are also decoding in the same manner or not. You have to ensure that also, and that is our ultimate goal. Thus, conscious efforts must be made to examine the impact of your video which you have prepared on the viewers for whom you have prepared, and so that the video can be improved to have better instructional value. And this evaluation will bring about a qualitative change in the final output of the instructional video, which can be used for number of years. So to evaluate the educational video, a scale has been developed by me in one of my recent programs, and has been published in a book also, and reference I have given in your module, and which you can use as such also. The copy of that will also be given in the module. So as such you can use that, but there are different parameters that evaluation performer, that is audio assessment, visual assessment, compatibility, effectiveness of channel, and then examining the impact of video on viewers, that is in terms of knowledge gain, skill acquisition and attitude change. So for this, as per the objective of your video lesson, interview schedule you have to make, or the knowledge inventory or the attitude scale you will make, and will be developed by for keeping in view the messages which you have delivered in your video lesson. Then you will do the pre and post exposure scores, you'll collect the data from the viewers, some of the viewers. You can take a sample of 30 suppose viewers and can collect the sample, and pre and post exposure score can be calculated, and accordingly the overall score is calculated, and that can give you the view that whether it is fine or not. Following these all steps will convey you about the information about the suitability of your video preparation, and skill, imagination and management are needed at various stages of conceiving, execution, finishing and presentation. And important film script terminologies which you should always keep in mind and which can be required at any time during the production stage, and you are must be using these terms, that is zoom in is the increased focal length of zoom lens to give a lighter shot, zoom out to decrease focal length of zoom lens to give a loose shot, dolly, the camera moves in or out of the object, means your camera is moving with the object, with the train or crane like that, and then pan, moving camera head from side to side in horizontal plane, camera angle like high angle, photo on the left, low angle and eye level and bird eye view, then tilt, move camera up, down, vertical plane, tilt up, move camera upward, tilt down, move camera downward, and then trunk or truck, the camera moves left or right, changing the position but at a fixed level. Then crane, the create, the camera moves up down. Canted shot or Dutch angle shot, that is tilted 25 to 40 degrees to one side, causing horizontal lines be at an angle. So briefly, three phases can be considered, which we have just discussed in three different modules, that is the pre-production, production and post-production. Just to give you a brief idea about it, in the pre-production phase, we should know what we are trying to say. Know the profile of the audience. Do the need assessment, what is required by them. Write statement of the objectives. Idea discussion with experts. Then establish entry level of the audience, their background and everything. Decide treatment which you want to give to your video lesson. Then finalize format, then write the script, graphic plan. So these all things are required at the pre-production stage. Then comes the production phase. There you have to do the location survey, you have to do rehearsal, videotape recording of the program according to the script. So that all you have to do at the production stage. At the post-production phase, you have to do video editing, sound dubbing and mixing, preview and evaluation. And after evaluation, if changes are required, you will standardize it and utility strategy you'll make to make use of your prepared video film. So this is all about this lesson, but I would like that you should download at least one or two software in your computer, and you should try to do the editing as told by me in this lesson. So you should certainly try it and do editing of your recorded video lesson and all graphics and titles, and then evaluate your video by getting feedback from the viewers through a suitable inventory. And if you have prepared any educational or fun video, share your experiences, and you can even upload your prepared video at any forum, even on YouTube, etc. So I've given some references also in the manual, in the lesson, so you can use them if you want more information. And thank you for your patience, for listening. I hope it will benefit you. Thank you so much.